some guys have all the luck. They get all the breaks. That's right. My name's John Wright, and they're not. And I'll tell you what, when I make a decision, sometimes I have to make a decision. It's on the split of the second. And other times, I just wait. It'll take me about 3 days to think about things. Or even worse than that. Not worse than that, I guess. When I sleep at night, I work in my dreams. I never stop working. I see things that upset me, and I can tell you things, and I can tell you the reasons why, and I can tell you the motives behind the things why I'm saying it. Every action has an equal opposite reaction, you know. I met a scientist. I won't say I met him in person, but I met him here on the internet. And he ends up in Australia. And, you know, he's got a lottery system, and it's the wave theory. It's, you know, basically, it's Newton's law. And he's ripped it off, and he's created it, and he's made it his own. And, boy, I tell you, he got upset when I told him about it. And, you know, he pointed out to me on the way about something. But I figured it out as its motives, you know. But actually, it's covenant. You know, because when you start looking at something and you look at their motives and what cause and effect happens, I don't care what it is, whether you take a person that's, well, they're rattled all the time, they can't keep their finances and stuff together, they have all these little things that just can't pull it together, but you don't know why they can't pull it. Great person. And then you try to help the person, and you know what they do? It will dig a ditch and make things even worse. Why? Well, it has everything to do with compulsory. Maybe something's happened to that person in the past. Maybe the person becomes where they're selfish. You know, and with selfishness is covenant. And covenant also has motive. Now, I look at covenant is almost like a rule of law. It's actually a description in the Bible under a Ten Commandments. Thou shalt not covenant. Now, when you think of that, and a person becomes selfish, set, so, and stuff like this, they set themselves in a motion of conditioning. You know, they've conditioned their life on being, I'm going to be a puller, and I'm going to pull no matter what, and they may even put out a front, I wouldn't do such a thing, and they do such a thing, and their inner motives and stuff twist their inside of their guts, and they see other people doing things, and they see other people doing other things so easily, and they admire them. Well, they would like to do what they would do, but they'd like to take a shortcut to do it. Well, there's no faking working out, because if you want to row your mouth and you don't work out, you won't be able to row the boat right across the goddamn stream, you know? So, if you want to be strong and you want to be long, you're going to want to work out like my grandmother said. Now, saying that alone, if you work out, you want to be strong, you don't do this. Oh, by the way, my grandmother, if you can't own it, you can't have it. You can't buy it if you can't pay for it. Don't get into debt. Debt causes stress. You bring down your immune levels, and all of a sudden, when you cause stress, you've brought down your own immune system. Even though you're looking big and rah, 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 rah. Nope. You're expending all that extra energy on something you shouldn't have done. You're running out your battery. You're running out your clock. You know, when I say I'll run circles around people, I can run circles around people because why? They covet it in their minds. They look at somebody else and they want what they own. Man, I don't give a fuck what you own. Jesus Christ, I see these here people of what they own. They want to go like this and go, well, that's just fucking fine. How do you feel today? You know, I used to tell my family members that was in debt, when they're all fucking running around with their heads cut off because the economy was terrible and it was George Bush that done it to them, with him and his war and their 9/11 bullshit. The cops, right there. You know why it happened on 9/11? Because for one, somebody's saying that the cops are involved in it. It's a direct message to the cops. The cops are in the middle of it, and the cops are in the middle of it today. The shit that you see around the United States of America is no more than the little red rum, the little red sucker that infiltrated the United States of America, and I could show you through cause and effect how it has happened. Now you look at the B-51 Lancer that just bombed in the Middle East, that was sent out of Texas. Lancer. John F. K.'s name, code name is Lancer. Why did that come out of Texas? Cause and effect is because this here whole thing in the Middle East is over John F. Kennedy. It stems all the way back to the murder of a president that happened when I was a 3-year-old child, and I was named after the president of the United States because they wanted to name their next boy after the president of the United States. I'll tell you what, this is the Zodiac, this is the D.B. Cooper, this is the stolen money, and the motives of all of that runs right back to the Republican Party, and that is what you're seeing across the United States. Cause and effects will happen to it. Another thing, when people are blurring out, they're saying things, untruthful things about personal attacks on Joe Biden, Jill Biden, and all these things that don't have nothing to do with politics. Jesus Christ, you look at the paper, you look at the fucking things, and you look at the facts. You look at the fucking motives. Donald Trump talks with the only motives that he has is because covenant. If he wants to keep things that don't belong to him. He wants to live off of other people's money, and he don't have real wealth. What he has is like this. The more deficit you have, the more wealth you have. Because you know what? He's in so much debt. They don't want Mr. Trump to go bankrupt because he owes so much that it'd flip the goddamn economy and it'd go straight fucking up, and all the Republicans know it. And the Democrats and the American people are starting to see the decibels on the stuff tapering off, jobs, strength. People are getting agitated, and who are they getting agitated at? Little Donald Trump sitting on TV saying, if we don't win the election, there may not be another election. Why? Because they think they're going to shoot up the town and take it over by force. I'll tell you what, Democrats, load up your guns, and if you hear any Republicans out there, blow their fucking brains out. You blow their fucking brains out. You see them with an M16, M15, you start hearing gunshots and stuff like that, and it isn't your United States military. You'll know what to do, men. You'll know what to do, men. Because I'll tell you what, anybody that's been threatening me around here, you know what I start telling them? You guys, you might have your little guns, but all these Democrats outnumber you. They want to take all the Democrats' rights away from them, they won't give up their rights. They'll hide their guns. They'll pull them out and they'll use them by force. And they'll also use bitter words to you. And they'll say things to you, little clues and stuff. And I see through clues, and I see covenant, I see greed, I see lust, I see sloth. I can go on and on and on. And what you gonna do when the truth hits you right in the face and you gotta see me sitting right here in front of you? My name's John Wright and you're not. I haven't been in the store for 10 years. Matter of fact, I don't think I took a bath last year. I could smell my goddamn crotch and I'll beat you up. Cross me. You crossed me. You just put an X on your goddamn life. Then your motives and your covenant will put you in the grave. You know why? Because it's your own motives that will get you. My son's mother. You know, I will tell you this. I love the woman so much. It hurts to say something negative when a negative remark can hurt somebody so much that it could bring down their immune system. When you dump on someone, you shouldn't. And when you go and you dump on somebody and it has a negative effect and you drive that person down and down to make yourself bigger, you have just did something. You think you've gained something. You have failed in the eyes of everyone around you. They see you as a bully. How can a bully be a leader? A leader is somebody that's loved. A person that loves people, does things for people. And love knows no barriers. And I don't know how people stop loving people. And I found out it was all motive, because people are forcing people to comply or people would die in my life. But now, what's their motives? What makes you sick? You know, lying can make you sick. Have you ever heard of you are what you eat? Well, if you eat at McDonald's every day and you get fucking fat, out of shape, don't blame McDonald's for being your fitness expert. You know, if you eat good meat, good nutrition, I'll tell you what, that'll give your body motive to get better. Every action has an equal opposite reaction. You know, when I found myself outside in a field and I started looking at things different, I started looking at the buds of the trees growing. When I go outside, I could see things at different times of the year. So just like the rhubarb that came up on the 5th of this month, and just 3 days later, I hear geese. You know what? That tells me, for one, I seen that. 3 days later, hey man, that happened. Now here comes the geese. When I see that happen, I can pull out my shotgun, put bullets in. I'm going hunting. And by the way, if you fuck with my gun rights, I'm coming after you. I've never threatened anyone with a gun, but I've been threatened by guns. And anybody what has an F-15, 16, whatever, automatic weapon and stuff, you start blowing that motherfucker off on me, you become on my radar, and you know what? You snap, you say one motherfucking thing, I might break your fucking bones and say, that fucking gun never helped, you did it. I don't need a gun to break your fucking neck. Isn't that nice? Now, you give me motive, every action has an equal opposite reaction, and I'll tell you what, if you're sick, you know what you do? What caused it? Face your fears. Get ahead. Get stronger. You will live longer. That's my message this morning. It's covenant. Covenant. Looking at someone else's property and think that it's yours. You have no right to my property. You have no right to my life. You have no right to my children. And if you ever lean on me and one of my friends, I will come after you. I don't give a fuck who you think you was. Because you will not be anyone when I get done with you. I could dismantle you with my words. But I'll tell you this one right now. If I can't beat you inside, I will beat you outside. Matter of fact, I might slam your head in the door while I throw you out of my goddamn house. Don't ever pull shit near me. I'll break you in half. And that's what you do with cancers and stuff too. Covenant causes a lot of stuff. Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him with kindness. The woman right here, she has a powerful word. Maybe people should listen to it. Take it to heart. I have to get off here. Hey, good morning. And if my ex-wife sees this, I love you. I love you. And I'll always love you. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much. My name's John Wright. I'm an American.